automotive industry in Formula One and in space programs, but it brings some problems because this program haven't been created for design so small parts as we do. This is just for real aircraft, real cars. All process start with choose of aircraft and its versions. This is how this is our on our CEO. He let us know his requirements like this, and we filled up some magazines, studied the versions, the differences among the versions. And select one of the drawing for design, and then we visit the nearest museum where is the aircraft, and we take some photos, videos, and some dimensions with laser meter and digital projector. Then we redraw this draw to the computer and correct it by our measured dimensions. And now we can start the main 3D design. We put the cuts, the sections to the space and using them for the mesh surface. In this time, must be the designer really sure how will all model separated on the parts. If the designer is ready with the mesh surfaces, next is the shell. The thickness of the shell have some minimas and maximas. If you want, we can discuss about it in the end. The designer must watch over all parts. It must be moldable. It doesn't mean that all faces on part have to be up or plumb. It's 90 degrees to the dividing planes. Next, we design small parts and details as the wheelbase, cockpit, armory, and so on. The most difficult is design some details which are very small on real aircraft, and on the in the scale they will be too small. Here is the space for compromises, but some compromises aren't popular. As the tube on this part, this is the real photo. Last is engraving and the rivets. Normally we use the drawing and the pictures for best fit. Then we create the whole part assembly create some analysis like a consistency analysis and clearances analysis. Thanks to this, we are sure that no parts crashed to the other part. This assembly is used for instruction sheet and for resin parts. Then the designer created the dividing planes. These planes, show you which faces go to the top, to the core, to the cavity. when the technology deploys the parts on the mold, he must come with a lot of principles. For example, the small parts have different plastic flow than the big parts and must have different dimensions between the part and the main intake. Then technology creates the core and the cavity by dividing planes. Some parts are designed as the inserts. Thanks to this, we can easily change those parts for other versions. The last are electrodes. The electrode look like a final part, but without the shell. It has the cube for fix into the ADM machine. After that, the technology sends this mold assembly to the manufacturer. This process shows if the parts are consistent. If not, the milling tool may crash. This process is very difficult. You must count with two parts speed, the spindle RPM. You must find the best milling tool diameter for each detail, and so on. The time we spend on this process is directly proportional to the quality of the initial space. Last is the machine simulation, because crash the virtual machine is cheaper than crash the real machine. Yeah. And all manufacturing data are translated to the milling machine language. This is I mean the wheel, for wheel 109. You see it? And they are milling. The designer has two other duties. First, he must check the quality of inserts and of the electrodes. And second, he must check the quality of final plastic parts. All processes take more than 1 year. But we are still trying to reduce this time. Some years ago, this process take more than 2 years. This whole process will I show to you. You have some questions? Or?
Is it not dangerous to shorten the process? You make more mistakes if you are working faster.
Is it dangerous?
Yes, because when you work faster, you are more able to do mistakes.
We try to reduce this time without mistakes.
In general, not only your model kit, if you work faster...
Yes, not faster as crazy man, but faster with
technology.
Increase the...
Efficiently, more efficiently.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and
maybe I can add something to the speech of standard. It doesn't mean that we will work faster, but it means we will reduce the time that is necessary for all the phases of the design. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes you can use, for example, the programs for the milling machine that was used in the past, just changing just one little part of the program. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is one of the options. Such a way or such a kind of options is many, many more.
Yeah. And it's one more thing, but the second is the spool process. Cooperation with the manufacturing team and with technologies team. Yeah. We must prepare something for them, and simplify then the work. Mm-hmm. And there is the time which we spend.
It is a question of organization of the workflow. Because we still see some gaps in our workflow that should be profiled, and this helps us to create all the designs and all the technology steps quicker and to have the result which is necessary for another step sooner than before. And this is the way how we do it, and as it was mentioned by Standa, in the last few years we were able to cut the time that is necessary to prepare the roughly to half of the original one. So our aim or our task is to reduce it to another half, to quarter of Formula One. So this is our task, and it is an internal thing. And it is a question of the workflow, of the organization, of the whole team, because the team is not the designer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the team is quite big. It consists of roughly said 9 to 10 people, because it was pretty good seen from the picture that are on the wall.